John Bills is the first to be sentenced as part of a massive conspiracy in Chicago's red light camera program that was first uncovered by the Chicago Tribune 4 years ago. According to testimony at federal trial in January, he took up to $2,000 in bribe money for every one of the 384 red light cameras that now pepper the city. And as part of this four-year investigation that began with us exposing that relationship that he had with this camera company, the Tribune has been able to expose mismanagement, failed oversight, corruption, and a very dubious safety record of the program itself since it began in 2001. John Bills had a long-time relationship since 2001 with a company called Redflex Traffic Systems, which was hired by the city of Chicago under Mayor Richard Daley to install the red light cameras for the purposes of keeping drivers safe throughout the city of Chicago. It's been a controversial program from the very beginning, but what we were able to discover is that from the very beginning, John Bills, who was at the time the number two person in the Chicago Department of Transportation, was involved in a very cozy relationship with them where he steered the contract to them. According to testimony at federal trial, he manipulated evidence at the pilot program to favor them. He rearranged votes at City Hall. He moved to give them a sole source contract on the program. He coached them on what lobbyists to hire at City Hall and what politicians to court. And he was intricately involved in growing the Chicago's red light camera program to the largest in the nation. In exchange for that, the company, Redflex Traffic Systems, was paying him for every camera that was involved. It was sending him on lavish vacation trips, bought him a condominium in Arizona, bought him a Mercedes-Benz, a boat, and all told, through a bagman at City Hall that was hired at John Bills' request, paid him up more than $2 million in bribes over the course of that decade. So in 2012, the Chicago Tribune began exposing these problems. The federal government opened an investigation. Now the former CEO of Redflex has pleaded guilty. The bagman has pleaded guilty. The top salesman for the company has pleaded guilty. And John Bills was convicted at trial in January. 20 counts of extortion, bribery, conspiracy, and fraud. Part of this investigation that started with the corruption, the Tribune has been able to establish that the program itself hasn't really done what the city has suggested it would. It's always been about safety and not about revenue. And while it's raised more than $700 million in traffic fines since it began in 2002, its safety record is dubious. We commissioned a study a couple years ago that found that nearly 40% of the cameras are likely to be making our intersections more dangerous. Bills is the first person to be sentenced as part of this conspiracy. Next up is the bagman, the person who the company hired to funnel the cash bribes to John Bills over this decade. He's set to be sentenced in September. And the former CEO of the company, Karen Finley, who approved the scheme, is set to be sentenced in November. The top salesman is going to be sentenced at some point in Ohio for his role in that scheme. And the Chicago Tribune will be at the sentencing and continuing to cover this ongoing scandal. Well, the only questions to remain unanswered is who, and one of Bills' contentions throughout this is that he's a bureaucrat and he didn't have control over a $120 million contract, and he didn't have the authority to orchestrate or the wherewithal to orchestrate a $2 million bribery scheme, and that the real people responsible are above him. So it remains to be seen whether or not those people will, if they exist, will ever come to justice.